She's a runner, she's a track star. She gon' run away when it gets hard. She can't take the pain, she can't get scarred. She hurt anyone that gets involved. Don't wanna commit, why take it this far? She gon' do the race, just not this one.
Guys, welcome to my channel, Life with Lisa. I'm here today and I'm going to do some roast fish, but it's oven roast fish. So now I'm going to clean my fish and get ready. So here's my fish. It's not much to clean because when I bought them, they were already very clean. You can see, not much clean. So I'm just rinsing and seasoning. So now I'm seasoning my fish, not putting too much on it. So it's just a little dash of the one, the first one that I put, it's my all-purpose, and the second one is fish seasoning. This one, garlic powder, and a little olive to my fish. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna cover this. Let me see if I can hold it. Right, I can. So I'm gonna do this. Fish have a lot of bones, so I cannot rub it in. So I have to do it like that, shake it so it can get all over them. So if you can see it here, you can see that it's all over. Ouch. See what I'm talking about? And it's on both sides. Okay, I don't put any in the belly because I'm gonna stuff it. I'm gonna stuff it so I don't need to put any seasoning in the fish belly. So this is my season, all my fish all seasoned up. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to prepare my onion and everything. What I'm going to prepare is my stuffings. I should say I'm going to prepare my stuffings for my roast fish. For my fish, I'm scraping my carrot. Prepping for my stuffing. Now I am washing my seasoning for my stuffings. I'm using a small onion, nothing big. Your stuff and you can do it big or small, whatever you like. Using half bell pepper, sweet pepper. I don't want to put a lot of thyme in it because thyme can take away the taste from your stuffing. You know, the thyme is very strong, and if you put a lot in there, it will take away the taste. The only thing you'll be tasting is thyme, nothing else. Alright? I'm going to use just half of carrot because it's not a lot of fish. So I'm just going to use half of the carrot, not the whole carrot. Now I'm doing my okra. Stamina thing, right? What them say, the guys them like, because it's strong up them back, and I don't know what else. So, then my okra, you notice how my okra is very soft and nice. So it's not old. When it's old, it tends to be very tough and stringy. This is the right picked okra. I'm cutting up my garlics. Using two cloves and a smaller than one. It depends on how you love your garlic. Sorry, I'm talking a bit lower because I wasn't realizing. But it depends on how you love garlic. I don't like a lot, although I'm not cooking for me. But yes. So that's that. I'm still on my stuffing. I'm making my stuffing. So I'm putting about 1.5 teaspoon of butter. Some fish seasonings, some of my all-purpose, and then a little bit of oil. You can just put half a teaspoon or less, depending on how you like your season. So I'm adding some black pepper, and what I'm gonna do now, I'm going to rub this all in. Let's try to get that butter all combined with everything. And trust me, it smells lovely. See? It smells very good. I'm stuffing, preparing to stuff my fish. So what I'm doing, I'm cutting the sides, right? So this is my fish. Now I'm putting some stuffings in the bowl of my fish. Okay. That's it. Getting ready to put my fish on my oil. So what I'm doing, I'm rubbing a little butter over my oil for my fish. Right? So now I'm gonna place this fish onto my oil. Try to get all the seasonings off of it as well. So stuffed and stuffed. Some people like to cook their stuffing. I don't like to cook mine. I like to make my stuffing cook into the belly of my fish. So what I'm gonna do now, I put a little bit in here, although I seasoned it with butter. Put a little bit in there, and I also put some on top of my fish. Okay. I'm going to foil my fish. I like to at my this tight, very tight. Okay. I'm going to use a little extra piece of foil as well. So I wrap my fish tight as I can. Now I'm going to use another piece of foil. So I put it the other way. This way. Now I wrap my fold. I'm trying to wiggle there, but I like her at my hand. This is one down. This is a parrot, and I'm getting ready to stuff this fish. Here I go. Stuff it. All stuffed in. Some butter on it. I didn't cut this fish because it's very small, so I'm going to cut this one. But it's big. I'll make a slit in this boat, on both sides. I'm going to wrap this. Usually I wouldn't wrap this again, but it got a little tear while wrapping, so I'm going to put a small piece of extra foil on there. Guys, I'm going to pack my fish onto my pan. It's not very big, so now I'm going to put this in the oven for about 30 minutes on 35 degree. Okay guys, this is my fish, and my 45 minutes in the oven is, so let me see how this bad boy turned out. My word. Ooh, hot. Hot, I tell you, hot, I tell you. Sticky and gummy on my hand still. Okay. Well, I tell you, it smells delicious. It smells very good. That much I can tell you right now. Oh gosh. Guys, you need to be in this kitchen, I tell you. You need to be in this kitchen. Look at this. finished product of my fish. Everything in the belly is all cooked and smells yummy. Oh my god! So now I'm switching it onto the plate. How nice and clean that is. So guys, please remember to like, share, subscribe, and comment. And don't forget to hit that notification bell. Whenever I upload a new video, you'll get a notification that Lisa is here, whether cooking or doing something else. You never know. Until next time. Until next time, guys. Peace. I'm out.